everybody. Thanks for joining us. I'm Kate Merrill with this WBZ News update. A woman is dead after an accident in Norwood. MBTA police say the woman in her 50s was crossing Broadway Street Friday morning when she was hit by a construction vehicle. She died at the scene. The driver of the vehicle was taken to the hospital for shock. MBTA owns the equipment called a swing ladder. It's being used for a nearby construction project. Boston police made a drug bust at a Dorchester barbershop. Police say they found 150 grams of fentanyl packaged for sale. They say the drug trafficking organization was being run out of the VIP barbershop on Erie Street. Four men are facing charges. Conservation officers rescued a hiker who fell down a steep summit in New Hampshire and broke her leg. This is a picture from near the scene of Mount Monadnock. We're told victim's husband called 911. After his wife lost her footing and fell, several rescuers helped her down the trail. She is expected to be okay. Dunkin' is dropping the donuts in some locations. The word donuts, that is, not the actual donuts. The Canton-based chain says they want people to think of them as a destination for coffee, though they will still sell donuts. They're just testing the new name in some stores in California. Let's send things over now to meteorologist Pamela Gardner with a look at your forecast. Pamela?
All right, more summer heat this afternoon. Low to mid 80s for those highs and an isolated storm chance popping up mainly to the north and west of Boston. Overnight, patchy fog, muggy, increasing clouds and a low of 68 degrees with the wind from the south and east. Now, you see this afternoon, most of that rain does stay away from Boston and away from southeastern Mass. But then overnight tonight, a cold front approaches very slowly. We'll see these scattered showers and storms starting to develop by Saturday morning. They stay out to our west, and then Saturday afternoon, anytime between noon and say 8 o'clock, that's when we have the chance to see those thunderstorms, and any storm that does develop could be strong to severe. The last little bit of rain pushes through at about 8 o'clock, and then overnight going into Sunday, much drier. But those impacts with the storms will be heavy downpours, large hail, damaging wind gusts too. That's going to be one of the primary impacts there. Isolated tornado threat as well, mainly away from the coastline. But after we get through the stormy, humid, hot weather for Saturday, PanMass Challenge riders, you'll be happy to know Sunday it gets less humid, full sunshine, but it's going to be slightly cooler and it'll feel a lot better for the riders there. 7-day forecast, more 70s for next week as we continue the cooling trend. Kate?
Pamela, thank you. I'm Kate Merrill. This has been a WBZ News update.